Hey guys, I'm passing through Southern California. I can't not say hey to my buddy Sam at the Electric Bicycle Center in Fullerton.
Yep.
It's been actually a fun day. I met a couple customers earlier, and now things are slowing down, so I was hoping you could just share some updates and a little shop tour.
So we're booming along here. We're carrying over 20 different brands of bikes.
Nice.
Let's go give a tour of the shop.
Yeah, let's do it. First thing right here, Reese and Mueller. When did you start carrying them?
Interbike. I saw them at Interbike, and I saw Chris Nolte there.
Yeah.
And I was like, that's a brand that I don't have, and I'm interested in carrying that. So I spoke with Eric, and we discussed bringing in the product line. And I think you have to buy like in with like 7 models.
Yeah, it's an expensive brand to carry.
It is.
Yeah, it looks, oh man. I was really impressed. I want to check some of these out. I've seen the Daily Grinder from Bulls, but then this new Rebel from Easy Motion. It's like a gravel grinder with drops.
Yeah, and it's got the Yamaha PW motor on it.
Sweet, sweet.
And then right next to that, we've got the Fantic with the drop bar. And we've actually taken this around the Fullerton Loop.
Yeah, that's kind of interesting. It's like mountain bike set up with drop bars.
The person who's running this is Steffi, and she is the only woman that I know of that actually raced Supercross in Anaheim.
Huh.
Back around, 99, 2000, I think.
Wow. Interesting. And then those are some of the recent Muellers. So was that the Nevo step through?
We got the Nevo. We've got a Roadster in the corner.
Some delights.
We got a couple of the delights, yes. So a little. I think besides ourselves, you can also check these out at Fly Rides.
San Diego Fly Rides.
And in Hollywood as well. So
really?
they've got two shops now. And I think the both of us are carrying the Reese & Mueller brand.
Okay.
Here in Southern California.
Well, and I can't. Okay, so right next to it, this Best View one.
Yeah.
I've been excited to check that out for a while. I haven't seen it too many places.
Yeah, James has been very persistent in this getting this in here, and so we brought in a couple different sizes, and we have it here for test ride for the customer as well. It's got the unique battery that goes down.
Yeah.
Large size battery too for someone looking for maybe a little bit longer loop that wants to go around. A longer, loop around when they're mountain biking.
You guys are always riding the Fullerton Loop nearby.
Yep.
This one always reminded me of like Bumblebee from Transformers.
Yeah, it's got some unique lines to it for sure,
yep.
No doubt, and the plus size tire as well.
I'm hoping to, come back and spend some time actually reviewing bikes at some point. But, Sam has just a ton of Easy Motion, a lot of high bike.
We love high bike.
Big blowout, yeah, lots of stuff and some really fun, bright colors. Do you have a favorite? Like, there's a million.
Well, my favorite was the 2016 All Mountain RC with the 400 watt hour battery on. And now you can get it in a 2018 model, which is basically this one right here, the All Mountain 6.0.
There we go. Okay, does that have the Yamaha PW or?
PWX.
I was wondering. That's the newer one.
Yeah, so the e-bike of the year was the All Mountain 8.0. We just sold it a couple days ago. And those bikes are going fast. I don't think they're going to last through the end of the year, whereas in years past, they'd always have extra inventory, and you got those awesome deals on last year's model. For going into the next year, I don't think you're going to find that on the All-Mountain 10.0, 8.0, or 6.0s. They're moving through them pretty quickly.
Well, I remember in years past talking about just the frame size. So there would be occasionally some deals, but it was tough to find the right size.
Yeah, so you'd get either the extra larges or the smalls, but I know for the 2017 models, they've been going quick at these blowout prices, but there were certain models you could get in all sizes.
Yeah.
And now it's getting thinned out, and we're back to what it was like before in 2016 to 17, where you can only get maybe an extra large or a small.
They're going through some interesting transitions, like
yes.
They're owned by the Excel Group, which carries iZip and Raleigh, and you got some iZips over here, some of the older Zumas, it looks like.
Yeah, those were both trade-ins, and then we actually brought iZip back into the fold along with Raleigh. Down here at the end and over on the other side of the lineup there, you'll see the iZip lines for 2018. The new style Zuma and the new style Dash is on the showroom floor as well.
With mid-drives, yeah, because the old ones had the hub motors.
Yeah, we started selling this style, I want to say around 2010 is when they came out with this, and it went through a few iterations, changes over the years. And in my opinion, they kind of priced themselves out of the market. It went over like the $2,500 price point.
Yeah.
And the new ones are like priced very attractively around, I think, $1,800. So they're more affordable.
I was just there. We got some reviews coming from.
Yeah, and
they're
really cool.
Yeah.
I think they did a really good job of choosing and picking the areas where to put the money. Like the Kevlar line, Schwabi tires.
Yeah, nicer tires.
Maybe a little bit cheaper shifter, on the new 18. Love the mid-drive. I love the power delivery. 48-volt, 500-watt. It is awesome, and the power is nice and smooth and gentle. With 48 volts, so many bikes are too herky-jerky for the customer.
I agree.
That bike, if you drop it down the lower levels, and let's swing down here really quick. Look at how low the seat height is on the low steps. I had a gal in today who actually was trying this out, and look at how low to the ground you're on that. There's not a lot of bikes. I mean, the tires, 26-inch tire, and the seats, you know, like right yeah. out here.
Really easy to approach, and yeah, stronger step through design here too because of the double yeah. tubing, nice battery. It's, you know, I agree, man. One of the things I've always really liked about their display panel is they pack a lot in here. There's actually a range estimate, and there's like this yeah. mini USB port for people who want to do their phone. That's pretty nice for the value on this, you know.
Exactly right. And again, you know, it doesn't have a big LCD here, but again, to get the price point attractive, yeah. they had to pick and choose what components to use, and I think they did a really good job with the iZip Zuma.
Okay, yeah, me too. Yeah. It's neat to see both side by side. Okay, and then over here we had some more Bulls.
We got the full lineup of Bulls pretty much.
It's been a good
full
brand
lineup
for you.
From, yeah, and the great thing is they're local. And Fernando and especially Barney, man, he's my man over there. Anything I need, I actually called Barney today. He was in Vietnam. He was at a bar
really?
Over in Vietnam, and I called him up, and he's like, hey, I'm over here. And I'm like, I bet you're loving it. And he's like, yeah, it's totally cool. And he's like, I'll tell you stories when I get back. He's coming back on Friday night.
Awesome.
So I had an issue, and I called him, and I forgot, oh, he's over in Asia right now. He's in Vietnam in a bar, and I call him up like on a Sunday afternoon here, and he's over there. He said, I'll be up for another hour if you need anything. Just call me up. Super great guys over there at Bulls.
Good stuff. Yeah, I agree. They've been really, you know, I'm not a normal customer. I sort of get extra special treatment from most of the brands, but Bulls especially. Like, they're just, it's a smaller team that's like really nimble.
Adam and Fernando and Barney and the whole crew over there.
Okay, so that's a great call out. Some of the other, what are these here? Is this a Juice? Do you carry Juice?
Well, so they kind of phased out the dealer network. If you want a Juice, you have to buy it direct. I have two left on my showroom floor. One Ocean Current, one Cross Current.
Three. This is old school.
This is a trade-in, and I was getting some ODK 500s. We kind of were informed at the end of last year that Juice is just going to be selling direct. And if you're wanting, I think it's John Marconi down in the Cyclist in Costa Mesa who's going to be doing the American Flyer.
That's right.
He's building a new dealer network. And he'll be building that network up. The ODK 500, though, which was Tora's baby, that was the first bike he built. I've probably sold three or four brand new ones since the first of the year, and we're in March now.
Wow.
So they're finding some in the back rooms or up in the loft, and they're kind of building them specifically for us because mm-hmm. there is still a demand for that. And so we're letting customers know that, or they're seeking it out and they're coming to me, and we're providing them with that.
You do
that
have
brand.
Such a unique selection. You know, part of the reason it's like I try to do shop tours occasionally, and I'm not trying to like over promote you, but he has so many of these unique brands and stories because you're here and you've been in the industry for so long.
That's the key thing, is we've been in it for a long time and there's room for everybody, and coming into our store and seeing kind of what's going on may give someone else an idea of like, hey, I can do that too. Let's open up an e-bike shop. I have half a dozen e-bike stores that will call me quarterly and say, what's up, what's new, what's going on? And then we'll kind of meet up with each other at an Interbike. But on an annual basis, they'll call me a few times a year like, what do you think of this brand? Or how's this going for you? What's yeah. been your experiences with them? So we kind of give that soundboard and we kind of like help people out as best we can.
That's what this is. And your customer base here, you've got, I mean, right down here, day six, I got to review one of these at your shop. Again, one of the only places I'd ever seen it. And there's this really interesting, like laid back, sort of recumbent, like feet down, for big riders too.
Another great guy, Kelly and his daughter running this company. They brought it back actually. They'd sold it and he bought it back, and he's passionate about what he does, you know, and he's a great guy. I've known Kelly for years meeting him at Interbikes when I first saw him. Yeah.
Wow. And other shout outs, you know, Motive, Ejo's local down in San Diego, the High Bike Radius Tour. Do you have any updates on these guys?
We just took Willie to a buffet dinner about 2 nights ago. We hung out and talked.
Where was my invitation,
Sam? You weren't here, man. You should have stopped by. But yeah. Willie's a great guy. He actually went to a new factory, and there's the 2018 model, and then we call it the 2018 and a half.
Okay.
I don't know if you remember the Ejo Epic SE that we did with the leafy throttle.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, there's a new display on it. The bike's about a half inch shorter. He's using a whole new factory in China. And there's been a few subtle changes on that bike.
Yep. Wow.
So he also has the Goddess and he has the Coda. And the Coda is very similar to your juiced
cross current.
Yeah. Exactly right.
So is this a speed pedelec?
But I think it tops out at around 25 miles an hour.
Okay.
Yeah. And when you say speed pedelec, it's anything over 20 miles an hour.
Yeah,
so
that's true.
It might be 24, it might be 26, and depending on the rider's weight, you know, you might be thinking, wow, it claims it's 28 mile an hour bike. You get on it and you're kind of disappointed because it only goes 24 miles an hour.
Speaking of which, I mean, we've done test rides in the past and it looks like you've been riding a lot, Sam. So you're losing some weight?
I'm down about 35 pounds since the first of the
year.
Good for you. So eating more healthy and no more fast food, no more sodas. And I got to represent, you know.
Yeah, look at all this stuff. And just what a beautiful, your shop has never looked better, man.
Thanks. And we have you to thank a lot for that as well because of all the videos you've done and all the support you've given the e-bike community. A lot of people come in here, they've seen our videos, and we can't thank you enough. We feel blessed, actually. Absolutely.
Oh, thanks, Sam. Yep. Me too. And it looks like you still carry some scooters.
We are phasing out. So we were talking earlier about like the low seat height on the Zoomin over there.
Yeah.
Yesterday, I actually talked with the president of the Small People's Association of...
For bikes? Is there
No, of America. Oh. So he had an 11-inch inseam.
Whoa.
And he was looking for a scooter. And I was like, kind of out of that, you know, we're kind of phasing out. We're just focusing on e-bikes now. We're not doing the kits anymore. We're not doing the gas-powered scooters anymore. We held on to the lithium-powered scooters. We had about five or six different brands.
Yep.
The Glion, the U-Scooter, the Eco-Rico, the Momos, and the
IMAX. Yeah.
So I have two IMAX S1s left on the showroom floor. Once those are sold, we're pretty much done. I'm probably going to give a referral, give all my parts in the back. I'll continue to do service work for anyone that's bought one from me over the course of the next year while they're under warranty.
That's nice,
and then I'll forward them to the person that I'm going to kind of send that customer base to.
You know, that's probably a good transition. It looks like you've got this place just chock full of e-bikes, and that's like your specialty.
Yeah. Our new slogan is work smarter, not harder.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, I got that from a wise guy once.
Well, you know, this has been so much fun. It's wonderful to visit Sam's shop. They got a guitar in the back there, and then Myron the Cat and Kanika will be hanging around at some point. But I wish you a great, you know, year, 2018.
Yes.
Coming back probably.
Yes.
Do some reviews.
Yeah, let's do some reviews, and we'll get out in the parking lot and have some fun.
Okay, that sounds fantastic. What's going on back here? Hey, Kanika, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Oh, building some new bikes. Cool, my gosh. That's a special option. How have things been at the shop?
Good.
That's awesome. I hear you might be going back to visit some family.
Yeah.
And yeah, mm-hmm. Gosh, business has sure been growing. You got your hands full, huh?
Yeah.
Hey guys, made a friend here. This is Lonnie and Carol. And we were just talking earlier, you've been doing the little test rides on the bikes. What was the situation? You kind of gave me some
Have a motive bike that I've had about 4 years. We drive to Trestles, up and down to Trestles Trail.
Nice.
And so my wife was like, I've been walking. My feet are bothering me.
Yeah.
And I said, let's buy a bike. And so she wanted to buy a bike. And I said, you're not getting a bike unless it's electric.
Right.
She's like, well, I don't want an electric bike like yours. So she's moving into an electric bike.
Mm-hmm.
Throttle assist.
Yeah.
And low pedal enough assist. For pedal assist.
Pedal assist, not throttle. Throttle.
No yeah. Throttle.
I'm not really a biker chick. I'm afraid to just take off without me.
And you tried it a little bit here today. So the one has the trigger throttle that strays out of the way a little bit more, but then the Motiv did have the twist throttle.
I didn't use it.
Didn't use it.
No,
and, yeah, that good
it.
Thing.
I would want to
disconnect it?
Yeah.
And she found that the 48 was too powerful.
Okay.
So we're going to go with the 36.
So the 36. So that's really good to hear, because a lot of times when I do the reviews, it's like faster, more power.
No, sometimes
you want a little
want
mellow.
More power.
Well, I don't know.
It scares me.
Yeah, and I've already crashed on mine going too fast.
Oh, no. That explains a lot, Lonnie. I wasn't going to say anything. we're helping him get back on his feet, right?
On the jet ski.
What?
On the Wave Runner, I like that.
On the Wave Runner, she went 62 miles an hour. She wasn't afraid on Wave Runner.
You guys are living the life. I'm riding bikes.
Just go over 100.
It didn't. 60 miles an hour is as fast as they can legally go.
100 miles per hour on a jet ski would be ridiculous. That's awesome,
anyway,
you guys. I hope you find it. It sounded like you were looking at maybe a white step-through 36-volt motive.
Yeah.
That's what I keep hearing. Is that maybe where
with
you're going?
With the shock.
With the suspension.
That's it.
Are you listening, Cameron? That's what the people need. He's the guy who runs it.
So, because I ride mine, and it's a little rough on my hands.
Uh-huh.
My hands get numb. and I get tired of the throttle, holding the throttle.
Oh, that's true. Yes. Some of them have cruise control, but it's a very rare feature.
I don't have cruise control on mine.
Okay. Well, I wish you guys luck, and I appreciate the, just the, you know, talking on camera with you.
Are we on camera?
Oh, my gosh. Whoa.
Until you get on the bike.
Okay.
And then
can
once
we
you're
turn
ready.
The throttle off so I can't accidentally?
You
can unplug
I can,
it.
I can do that by disconnecting the throttle at the controller. But for right now, that throttle will be active.
Okay.
So be aware of that, that this part of the grip, if you twist
this
it.
Not this part.
Correct. Hold on to that part. You can hold there, just don't twist it.
Yeah. Okay.
And then you've got your full grip here. We're going to go ahead and turn the bike on.
Okay.
And you're in level, it defaults in the level one pedal
okay.
assist.
And if I want to lower the gear,
you pushed
lower?
It, exactly right. That's the way you lower it.
Lower.
Just like that. But you got to be pedaling
but
to do that.
You got
to
be pedaling first.
Okay. All right. Did I just ruin it?
It's got to kind of click down to the lower gear. There you go. Yeah, so it's very powerful.
Well, I was meeting another customer here. This is Jody. How's it going, buddy?
It's going good, yeah.
We were just getting ready to tell me your story about e-bikes. What? So how did you get into this?
It's interesting. So my wife had a road bike, or has a road bike, and she's been riding for a while. She's in a lot better shape than I am, and just looking for a way to get back into biking and be able to keep up with her.
Sure.
And came and talked to Sam and bought a Bulls electric bike.
Wow,
and,
last year?
About a year ago now,
okay.
Yeah. And it's been phenomenal ever since. Probably ridden over 1,000 miles on it. And
wow.
We've done a lot of different things together.
This is your wife here?
Yeah, it's my wife, Dana, yeah.
Hey, are you okay on camera?
Oh, yeah.
She's doing great. So it looks like she's convinced you might have her on a bike soon, too.
Yeah, we've been looking for a little bit, so I'm sure we'll be getting a bike soon.
You were saying it sounds like, I mean, high bikes is what I'm seeing, but there's a whole bunch of new bikes this year, 2018.
Yeah, trying to kind of figure out what the right bike is for her. You know, we're kind of looking for a good deal as well.
Sure.
So
has the Bulls been good? Like, what's your feedback?
So I have a 29, I forgot what it is, but the full suspension mountain bike, the 29er.
Whoa. Which motor?
It's got the Bosch motor in
it. Bosch, okay.
It's been phenomenally good. I'm not an aggressive off-roader with it, but it allows me to do a lot of things, so
okay.
It's fun.
Good, good. And yeah, having some fun and then staying in shape and now spending some time with your wife. What does she do in the past with her? Did you ride with her on her road bike?
Not very much with her road bike. I had a Trek hybrid bike when she had her road bike, so it was a little tough to keep up with her.
Okay.
But we now have two other couples that are our best friends. That one couple has electric bikes. One we were just with this weekend, and they're going to get a couple electric bikes.
Sweet.
And we've got some other friends as well. So for our age and for our group, it's just a perfect thing
perfect
to have an
fit.
Electric bike.
Can I go say hey to her real quick?
Oh, yeah, she'd love that.
What's her name again?
Dana.
Dana.
Yeah.
Dana, do you mind giving me the scoop here? How is this?
It's a smooth ride. It's like the big sedan.
You're a pretty good rider. It sounds like you do road biking, huh?
Oh, yep. I like to do road biking, but
this is the trekking model, or yeah, right. So it's kind of a hybrid. You got the suspension, and you think you go a little bit off road with him if you get something like this?
Oh yeah. So I was thinking the tires would be
yeah,
something
the
that
bigger, comfortable
would
ones. Gosh, the bikes these days are. I mean, this is super nice. Got the light and everything. You like the lightweight tires on that one? A little easier to handle.
So yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's what it is.
We got to take it off road to get the full experience,
right?
Right?
Exactly. That's but that was quick and fun.
Cool.
Are they going the same miles?
Probably similar. Very similar.
Do they both
What's
have
the range?
Yeah, it's the Power Pack 500. Is that the 400
that
or
500?
Oh, so they both are the 500 one. Yeah. So this
yeah.
is great.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, same motor. Looks like that one has like the less integrated motor. This one's kind of like angled in. And it looks like, yeah, both CX. Oh no, performance line. So this one's gonna be a little bit more efficient. It might go further. It's lighter, probably costs less. It has the, you know, this one gets 63 newton meters of torque, where that one gets 75. And it's a little bit more aggressive. Yeah.
But from the way we're gonna use it, this would be more than enough.
I think so, yeah.
The downside to this is I think it's a 28 mile an hour bike. And
this is a speed pedal X?
Yeah, mine's only 20, so you're going to be blowing by me all the time.
Well, I don't know. This one, it says just performance line.
Okay, well, maybe not, but I thought Sam said it was
It's sometimes the cases are incorrect. You can hop on there and be able to test.
I think I might have to.
Yeah.
I just know that I don't want to get her a 28 mile an hour bike when mine only goes 20.
Yeah, and then you'll be keeping up. You know, that's a nice bike. I'd be curious to see if it actually goes 28. It sounded like he'd gotten an e-bike a year ago. What's it been like? What do you think as his wife?
He loved it, so I was...
excited for him? He's getting out there more?
I was, but I was kind of skeptical, and then I borrowed a friend's bike, and now I won't.
You're convinced. Yeah. You drank the Kool-Aid.
Yeah. It's all... we live in Whittier in the hills, so if you take your road bike out, it's tough to come back home, but...
yeah.
But we can ride the hills. It's really, really fun.
That's fantastic.
I'm a convert now.
We said you guys have some friends that go biking, and do they have e-bikes too?
Yeah, they got e-bikes, so
okay.
I'm the only one without one, so
wow.
I have to do my road bike and try and keep up with them.
Maybe today's the day.
I know, it could be.
Have you been to this shop before and talked to Sam? No.
Jody, he's
he's a fan. Is this where he got his bulls?
Yeah, I think he did. And he goes to the e-bike convention too.
Yeah. Sam has like that party once a year or whatever here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the parking lot turns into an extravaganza. And then there's Interbike. That might be the festival that he went to in Las Vegas.
Oh, maybe. I don't know. I'm out. Getting mechanics. I'm like, oh, if it's comfortable. Bike.
Well, there he is. How fast did you go?
Not that fast, but it was awesome.
Yeah, okay, so 20 mile per hour?
Yeah, I think it's only a 20.
Well, guys, I'll see you back at electricbikereview.com, electricbicyclecenter.com.
Yep.
Have fun out there. Ride safe.
Bye.
Sweet.